Is anti-gravity propulsion actually possible? Well, it depends on how you actually look at this, because, as you know, mainstream science seems to embrace relativity. Now, Einstein's general theory of relativity is currently the most accurate way to predict gravitational interactions. And we have seen it predict many things, including orbital precession, gravitational lensing, and even time dilation effects on spacecraft. However, relativity does not explain the universe's acceleration and expansion, nor does it explain the rotational stability of galaxies. So this has led to a claim of dark energy and dark matter, respectively, but we have no idea what this stuff is. And this is kind of a mind-bender because Einstein's field equations are very accurate in specific applications, but it's not explaining what's happening in the universe, and that's a big problem. Now, obviously, we could sidetrack into several theories, including M-theory and quantum gravity, but they are very difficult to prove due to their effects happening at a very small scale. Basically, what I'm saying is that we do not fully understand what gravity is or how it can be manipulated. Now, this leads me to a very incredible event, commonly referred to the Tic Tac incident. Now, this event's really important because you have a very credible UFO testimony from a US Navy pilot, along with declassified official footage. So there's a very high probability that this thing is actually real and it is negating the effects of gravity somehow. And to me, it doesn't really matter if it's from a secret project or an off-world civilization, because it is demonstrating that gravity-defying technology does exist. Now, can we publicly build something which can manipulate gravity like this craft? Well, it starts with experiments, and something that has to be tested time and time again. So we have to be skeptical when we do an overview of anti-gravity devices, because most of them still need to be tested and verified. It's also highly probable that most of them do not work due to misinterpreted data, personal gain, or misdirection. But it's also very important to have open source experimentation, because this will reduce possibilities and lead us to the right path. So how far back in history do we have to go to get the first claim of an anti-gravity device? Well, we can actually go back all the way to World War II with Viktor Shauberger. Now, supposedly he built very unconventional devices which used water vortexes to establish very large forces. Some of his machines include a water filtering device, a mini typhoon machine which can manipulate temperature, and a generator powered by water jets. Now, they are pretty crazy inventions and we don't know if they're really real, but even Adolf Hitler met the inventor to discuss weaponizing water. Against his will, Shauberger was forced to work on the gravity-defying craft known as the V-Roll-7, but the war soon ended and the project was scrapped. Could we really have known how to defy gravity before we even built orbital rockets? Well, it depends if you believe in the story, but gravity research and disinformation became quite active after the 1940s. And not even a decade later, the Searl device was invented. And supposedly, this contraption produced anti-gravity effects, and it also supposedly produced free energy. Now, obviously, that is defying the laws of physics, and I'm very skeptical of these claims. But supposedly, it works by using a combination of magnets, and this creates a homing point for random energy, allowing it to become uniform and orderly. This has gathered a lot of attention, and even Russian SEG researchers have claimed to have made a new generation device which reduces or increases weight with rotation, up to a maximum of 7% deviation. Now, even if these devices are real, they are very problematic because they are expensive and they are very difficult to build. But they could prove that strong electromagnetic fields can have an effect on gravitational forces, and that would be pretty amazing. Now we fast forward a few years, and probably one of the most infamous electrogravitic effect was discovered by the infamous Podkletnov. Now this gentleman graduated from the University of Chemical Technology and received a doctorate in material science. He was well known for his early experiments involving YBCO superconductors which produced gravity shielding effects, and this would cause a weight loss of several percent. This was achieved by rotating very large superconductor disks at high speeds. NASA even got interest in this, and they tried to replicate his experiments in the late 90s. But this is where it gets controversial, because there were some notable unusual effects, but they immediately ran out of funding when Podkletnov started to get involved with the experiments. The Defense Department allegedly confiscated all the equipment, and its research was transferred to a separate corporate entity ran by Dr. Ling Li. Now, ironically, the Defense Department awarded a grant to continue the anti-gravity research, but nothing was made public after that. Podkletnov is also conducting experiments to this day with other composite materials, and he has claimed to produce more lifting effects. He has hypothesized that a certain rotation in material composition would create vector forces through gravity wells, but there has been no independent verification of his tests just yet. Now, this also leads me to another set of experiments done around the same time by Dr. Frederick Alzofon. And he developed a theory of gravitational interaction and modification based on the cyclic spin polarization of atomic nuclei. His son David Alzofon has made a book and he's actually landed several interviews on popular YouTube channels. He explains that weight can be manipulated through high pulse microwaves and electromagnetic fields, and it's essentially controlling gravity through a process known as dynamic nuclear orientation. The nice thing about this experiment is that it can be replicated if you can find the right equipment. And it's trying to be replicated by multiple people right now, including Hathaway researchers and even YouTubers such as Falcon Space Program and Alien Scientist. So I highly recommend to check out those channels, and I will leave those links in my description. Now, I'm going to end the video with a very controversial device made from one YouTuber. And just like the other contraptions, I'm not sure if this is actually real, but it's also based on some type of electrogravitic effect, and it could be similar to the Alzofon experiment. Now, he has multiple videos of his flying contraption, but unfortunately, he is Russian, so I couldn't really understand his descriptions, but it does seem to me that he's using a very high voltage Tesla coil, capacitor and counter-rotating magnets. From what I understand, he's claiming that voltages, frequencies, and ultrasonic sound can be used in resonance to produce anti-gravity effects. Now, I dug up whatever I could that breaks down his build in English, so also make sure to check out those links in my description. Ultimately, it's going to have to be replicated by someone else, and that will be the true test on whether this thing is real or not. So I know I didn't include everything, but it's very interesting to me that most of these contraptions are using magnetic fields to some degree. And a lot of these experiments seem to focus on the actual matter matrix, more specifically about the spin and orientation of subatomic particles. Now, if we can manipulate weight through atomic composition, then it does raise a lot of questions on how gravity interacts with matter. But if none of these devices work, then it could lead us to a better path as well. I'm a little bit more optimistic, and I think that one of these devices is real, and it will be able to be replicated. And I think in 20 years, we might see rockets as a prehistoric technology. So once again, thanks for watching. Please like the video if you enjoyed it, and also make sure to subscribe to my channel.